respected dignitaries present on the dais, of the dais, vice chancellors of different universities, directors of the institutes, dear graduating students, their families, our beloved faculty members, colleagues, staff members. It is an absolute honor to me here in the 7th convocation ceremony of USTM. I could not be prouder of everything you all have done in your time getting associated with University of Science and Technology. And of course, I would like to congratulate not only the fellow students, but also the teachers, counselors, parents, and family members who guided you all along the way. Now, graduating is a big achievement under any circumstances. Some of you have had to overcome serious obstacles along the way, whether it was an illness or a parent losing a job in this pandemic or living in a frightful pandemic situation. But the good news is that you all are in hold of most powerful degree. This is not only a degree. In the word of Nelson Mandela, known as African Gandhi, this is a weapon. With this weapon, you can do anything. It depends on teenagers and generation of this university. 1,332 students today receive a beacon. Are you ready to use this beacon in the interest of the Meghalaya, in the interest of the Northeast, or in the interest of the country? It's only depend on you. Are you going to take the challenge or you are not going to take the challenge? Education really is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Some are already, all of you, receive the degree. This convocation ceremony will have hold a very important place in your heart. It is this day in the academic life of the student when all the hard work, dedication, commitment, and enthusiasm pay off, getting dressed in traditional academic regalia with the convocation stone and walking up the stage for holding the prestigious convocation file in the dream of every student. One other thing would like to mention here. Actually, in fact, it's a dream of many parents too, because they have supported them in their difficult endeavors. Being called on the stage on this day gives an extra boost to your confidence and self-esteem. But the story should stop here. Now it is your duty to use this powerful beacon in the betterment of society and build a better world to live and let live. But what remains to you is that you all are into your adulthood. This is the time when you begin to take charge of your own life. It's when you get to decide what is important to you, the kind of career you want to pursue, who you want to build a family with, the values you want to live by. I will leave you with a few quick pieces of serious advice. First, don't be afraid. Be fearless and action-oriented The first commandment to success is to get into the action habit. Getting into the action habit or the habit of doing this will raise your odds of success tremendously. The second commandment of success is to learn constantly. Commitment to becoming an expert in your field. In fact, learn and commit to your craft and become number one at it. Try to build a community. No one does big things by themselves. If we are going to fight difficult times, if we are going to create a world where everybody has the opportunity to find a job and affordable college, if we are going to save the environment and defeat future pandemics, then we are going to have to do it together. Life is a mixture of good and bad, right and wrong, happiness and sadness, positive and negative, hero and villain, success and failure, opportunities and difficulties, peace and disturbance. Everything is complementary. You will agree that we learn to live life only after we face difficulties in life. Finding something you are passionate about gives you a sense of purpose and is a big part of happiness. To find it tough, you need to be honest with yourself, observant, and make the most of the situation. This brings to you my next piece of advice on finding this. Find the smartest pupil you can and surround yourself with them. In the last but not least, finally, on this wonderful day, when we are gathered together to celebrate your academic success, I have decided to talk you about the benefit of failure. Not only the success, also benefit, also the failure. And as you stand on the threshold of what is sometimes called real life, I want to highlight the crucial importance of failure. Success is never final, and failure is never fatal. It's courage that counts, and all of you have the capability. Again, would like to see, you have the capability, only it depends you are ready to take the challenger or not ready to take the challenges. Once again, thanks to the Vice Chancellor and Chancellor of this university for giving me a chance to discuss against you. Thank you.